comedy advice from two scientists.
Give it up. There's two scientists, everybody.
We're not drunk. We are two scientists.
We have not had plus five drinks each tonight. We're two scientists.
We didn't have any Hennessy.
We're two scientists. We're not half a bottle of Hennessy deep going into this. We study stand-up comedy. We're not comedians, though. We will make that very clear. We are not comedians.
We're not stand-up comedians. We're two scientists.
Two scientists.
Say that again.
See, now that's a goddamn comedian.
That was it. That was the big guy.
But that's not us.
That's the fat man? Well, you've got a laser pointer on you now, so who looks stupid now, huh?
He doesn't know what that is.
Oh, you silly little guy.
I'll fucking kill you.
I'm Dr. Rent Bead. I'm Latino.
Yeah.
I graduated from Harvard University. These are our qualifications as scientists. I studied linguistics and female anatomy.
Come on now.
Come on.
No, mom.
I know what a pussy is. Won the Nobel Prize for having great taste in comedy.
Those wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
These are good.
They're giving us your favorite comedian.
Oh, yeah. I also cured cancer.
What a great scientist. Can we get some noise for that? He cured cancer.
Cured cancer.
Thank you.
Are you guys a pro-cancer crowd? All right. And then this is me. Oh, I fucked up the slide. That was going to be a dramatic reveal at the end, which would be funny if I was a comedian. Likely, I'm just a scientist.
We're just scientists.
And a scientist can make mistakes on a presentation, can he?
Comedians
I don't know what AIDS is, but it seems like you deserve it.
Come and give it to me, you coward.
I'll kill you.
And I graduated the Ivy College of Business at Iowa State
University. That's actually true.
That's a real fact.
that's actually the truth.
I have an Ivy degree from the Ivy College of Business at Iowa State University.
Our research. We've been doing a lot of research. I've just been following Mikey around for 3 days.
That's been true. It's mainly what we've done, though, is we've watched...
we just watched both seasons of Crashing.
Yeah, we watched both seasons of Crashing with Pete Holmes. It's a goddamn great show.
Great show. You can sleep on any famous comedian's couch.
Yes.
Ever.
Yeah. Five episodes in, he was smoking weed for the first time ever with Sarah Silverman.
And you can do that. And
we've all
just go to one open mic.
Make some noise if you smoked weed with Sarah Silverman.
Woo! We all have, I think.
You cowards. I guess no one here is good comedians.
Oh, just a reminder, we are two scientists.
We are not comedians.
Not two...
Comedians.
The rest of this could really set our careers back if we were comedians.
Yeah. How to be great at stand-up comedy. Here's what we got. We got a list. You have to be... funny, original.
All this is bullshit, really.
Clever writing, captivating, unique perspective.
Waste of fucking time.
Pushing the floor. That's what we got. Who cares? Next slide, Brent, you can take this one. Super lame, we all agree on that.
Yes, yes.
How to move up.
Yeah, here's how you move up in comedy. It's a three-step process we accumulate with all of our research and studying and listening to Joe Rogan.
Go to open mics. You attend open mics. All this is also bullshit. You can skip all this.
All right.
You can skip all this.
I'm falling asleep now.
The pros to doing this method.
Yeah. Moral high ground. It makes noise if you love the moral high ground of spending years to develop your craft.
Yeah.
All right. Then there's cons.
Oof.
That is a lot.
Fuck.
That's... Wow.
Air mattress is right up there with debt, for sure. Yeah. And crippling debt.
That's a lot of cons. I would not want to do that.
Thank God we're just scientists.
We're not comedians, we're scientists. We don't do any of that bullshit. That's crazy. I'd not want to do that. Or here's the thing, though. You could go through that antiquated method, but we're scientists. We're pushing research. Here's what you could just do. You could just do crowd work.
All right, we have an example. I'll give an example. Sarah, what's your name?
What's your name?
Will, you're a dumb bitch, Will. See, crowd work, it's fucking easy, you dumb bitch.
Yeah, Will, you look so dumb in your green shirt. What are you, Shaggy from Scooby-Doo? Come on, okay, we're fucking
dumbass.
Doing it.
Dumbass, you can be hot, that's a good way to move up in the
stand-up comedy world. A lot of people being hot right now. Facial surgery, work for the goat.
Look at that picture on the left. Fucking haunting.
Hottie.
Yeah.
Hottie.
Marife.
Marife.
Isn't that fun?
Marife.
Lover boys, sexy, sexy man. You could also get ripped.
Yeah, we have all a right.
I'm doing a little Matt Rife thing.
Look at that. Put a light on that bulge.
Look at that bulge. You're lucky he's behind the desk, because there's a goddamn anaconda fucking swimming back here.
Yeah, you think there's a table under this.
Dear Lord.
Hey, I gotta, look happier on the left.
Yeah, I do. I was.
Homina. Now, here's the thing. Even when you were chunky, you still had a chance, because the third option is you just have tits.
All right.
Uh-huh. Come on now. Who doesn't like... Booked. I don't know.
You all these boys is booked.
You come here on a weekend, I'd watch that lineup, okay? That's a great-ass lineup. Great tits on that one, I'll tell you that. Reminder that that's bad. Had we been comedians, that would really piss off the host of this show.
Yeah, dude. We would.
Jack Timmons would never have us back had we been comedians. Luckily,
we're scientists.
We're scientists.
You guys are missing one key way to succeed as comedians. You got to worship the demon, Gorgoline.
Shut the fuck up, Scott.
Yeah, Gorgoline these nuts.
Yes.
Full on applause break.
He's got the best tits on stage. He gets to say jokes like that. You got a rack like fucking him. You can also use prop. Here's a prop comedy. People make fun of it. I think it's actually brilliant. There's two genres.
You can go two ways with it. You can go silly. Or you can go racist. You can do racist props.
And I'm not saying Jeff Dunham's racist, but you ever think about it? You ever stop down and think about what he's... And you know what? You're probably, Matt, you're falsely accusing Jeff Dunham of being racist. That's a joke, guys. Jeff Dunham's not
he's
racist.
He's got black friends.
He's got tons of black friends. And they love him, okay?
Look at him.
If you don't like this, you're homophobic and racist,
that
okay?
Black guy's there by his own free will.
Amen, brother. There's not a stool underneath him. Oh,
yeah. Here's another way you can become a famous comedian. You can become a regular on Kill Tony. There are two ways to do that.
Now, Brent specialized in this.
I prepared a Venn diagram as a scientist. So you can be two things. You can either be retarded or you can be black. Oh. But the best thing you can be is both.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
They're our friends. You guys hated that?
You guys didn't like that?
You know, they're good friends with all of them, except probably David.
That's correct. That is actually correct. Yeah, I barely know that guy. Here's a stipulation. This scientist forgot this one. Don't bomb on Kill Tony. That'd ruin your career. Also, don't look up episode 637 and skip right to the 49-minute, 54-second mark, okay? Because someone bombed really hard, okay?
Oh, catchphrases. Can I do this one?
Yeah, take this one away.
Hell yeah. So we got some catchphrases.
Boy, I hope this goes longer.
We're halfway done. Double down, cunts.
We got two more hours. Strap in, you sons of bitches. Jeff Foxworthy.
What does Foxworthy say? You guys know?
Not right.
You might be a redneck. Very good. Hamburger Jones.
What's he say?
Hot dog.
Hamburger. Hell yeah, and then we got Jack Timmons.
All right,
and what is Jack Timmons' catchphrase? The N-word.
No.
Say it right now.
Jack,
show us your catchphrase.
Say it.
The N-word.
Say it.
All right, you guys aren't fun.
There's a lot.
Pop quiz. Based
off of our research.
You guys remember the research here? Based on the last slide, which of those three comedians would most likely be a Kill Tony regular, okay?
Okay.
All right, what do you guys think? A, Jeff Foxworthy, B, Aaron Jones, C, this guy. What do you guys think? A, B, three, we'll count it on three, just yell whatever. Okay, one, two, three.
It's actually D, Jack
Timmons and Backlays. Yeah, you guys didn't consider that option. He does it all the time.
Black Timmons, yes.
Black Timmons. No one talks about it. And now that explains the bulge, huh? Doesn't it just a little more natural now? Come on now. Take over. This is what I'm passionate about. You can have famous or rich parents. That'll set you forward as a comedian. Here's some comics. Also,
as a bonus.
Bonus points. You could also just be Jewish. You guys ever do comedy in New York? I haven't. I'm a scientist. Thank God.
I'm still going.
We got some quick ones. Okay.
Some people get booked because they sell drugs.
This guy.
Legally.
It's legal.
Clean the bottle.
It's legal. It says it
it on there, legal and cool.
It's legal and cool, okay?
Some people only get booked because they do video.
Make sure it's for a videographer, Andrew Tarr in the back, everybody. Keep it going for him. That's the reason you book that fucking guy. His act sucks.
He's gay and black, too.
He is gay and black, and I'd book him in a heartbeat. Some of you only get booked, say, on a comedy club. And yeah, not just have you a good comedy, it could be any comedy club. If you just own any club, they will book you. And thank God I didn't make fun of Joe Rogan. If I were a comedian, that would really suck.
Yeah, that really fucking suck.
That would really suck.
I'm not a paid regular there and only
we'll end on this,
scientists.
Okay? We'll end on this. There's one thing you should never do in comedy, okay?
And that is?
Sabotage your career by aimlessly bashing everyone around you that loves and supports you for no apparent reason. Yeah. That's us.
We've been two scientists.
We've been two scientists.
And up for two scientists, everybody. Thank you.